Hey guys, this is me Sahid Kaul, and in this video, I'm going to show you my submission for the Sparks Foundation Grip task. So first of all, let's get started with what task I'm doing. First of all, let's go there and see. So this is my task, basic banking system. So in this task, I have to make a dynamic website using HTML, CSS or whatever I can, but it should be dynamic and the flow of the website should be homepage. View all customers, select and view one customer, transfer money, select customer to transfer to, and view all customers. And there is no login page or no user creation required in this website, so I have not done that. And I can use MySQL, Mongo and Postgres for the database of the website. So yeah, this is my task, and let's see how I've done it. So for the starter, let's see the code part of the website. So in this website, I've used HTML, CSS, Bootstrap for the front end. For the back end, I've used PHP and JavaScript. And for the SQL part, for the database part, I have used PHP MyAdmin SQL. So what you can see right now is the front page of the website, and the title of the website is written here. Then you can, as you go down, you can see the code for navigation bar. So what I've done is I've given navigation bar to every web page of my website. So this is the code for that, and in that after that I have given code for the carousel in only the home page. I've given the carousel code. So yeah, this is the code for that, and the carousel will also move like a slideshow. So the code for slideshow is this, and there are left and right controls also in the carousel. And after that, I have made a section for about us. What the about us means for the bank which the website depicts. So yeah, this is the code for that about us. Then there is a disclaimer which is showing that the project is a sorry the website is a project work, and it is does not resemble any individual or refer to any company or any organization. So yeah, after that I have given a footer class for the credits and all. That is the front page of the website. So next I want to show you the customer list of the bank which website will show you. So this is the code for that, and first of all, I have given the title our customer. Then this is the code for background color, which you will see in the website again, and I will show you. So as we go down, you can see the nav bar controls here. Same, I have given the codes for the nav bar as I have given in the front page of the website. Then as we go down, one thing you can see here is config.php. Now this is the code. This is the code for config.php. Now this code is the connection between the database and the website. So whenever we need a database in the website, this will initiate the web database connection with the website. So we will use this whenever we will need the database. So here you can see I have used this include.config.php here. And using this, it will initiate that connection. And after that, I have used, after that, these are the code for the table, which will be required for the database in the website. After that, it is footer code only. So this is the web page of cover customer list. So now let's jump into the main part of the website. Now this is the part which will, initiate the main functioning of the website. This is the transfer window of the website, and first of all, I have included my config.php, which will initiate the connection between the website and the database here. And so you can see the SQL query I have written for the how much amount of money will be transferred and to whom will be transferred and by whom will be transferred. All it will all will be it all will be updated using this query So yeah, after that you can see here there is a command for all the errors which will come while transferring the web money. Like if the user is inputting negative value, so there will be an error which will be thrown. With that, this error will be error negative value. After that, if the user is inputting insufficient balance, insufficient amount, and then the error will be thrown as insufficient balance. That means the user doesn't have this much money. After that, if the user is inputting a value of zero for transfer, it will also throw an error stating that error is zero value cannot be transferred. So after that, there is an else part. In this else part, what we can see is that the user the is this is the SQL query which will update all the amount in the sender account and also the amount in receiver account. Okay, after the transaction is completed, the page will throw a notification that transaction is successful. And this is the layout I have made for the website. As you can see, the title I have given here is the Easy Money Transfer, and there is a background color also I have set for the website, for the web page, and also the navigation bar code. And so now you can see here I have made a given the command for building a table. Now this table will show us the user we have selected for sending the money. And after that, there will be a box or label box which will show us to whom we have to transfer the money. Also, this will give us the option to choose the account in which we have to transfer the money. And then also we will use a database because we have to update and show the user what amount and how much balance it is balance has how much balance is left in the account. So yeah, this is the selected user detail.php part, means this is the transfer window part of the website. Next is the transfer history window, which will show up as soon as we have made a successful transfer of money. And this is the code for the transfer history window. What I have done is here, first of all, I've given the title of the page again. Then there is the code for nav bar. Here you can see the background color I have given to the web page. Then as we go down, you can see the class container for making the table of the web page. Then here also I have inserted the config.php because as soon it will update every transaction to the table, every transaction made to the table. So yeah, that's why I included that at config.php. So now this is the transfer history window. Now next, at last, this is the SQL query which will be used to maintain the database of the website. As you can see, I have given the command here for creating table. Then I have given the command to insert element in the table. Also, I have given the command for dumping the table uses data. So yeah, this whole is the SQL query for maintaining the database and updating it for the website. So as we are done with the coding part of the website, now let us jump to the output of this whole thing. So we will open the Google Chrome here, and then we'll paste the link which is provided by the web hosting services 000 web host to me, as I have hosted my website there. So yeah, this is the link. So this is our website here. This is the front page of the website basically, and you can see the carousel here works very nice. There is a control button for moving left and left and right. We can go left and right using this button. And also the navigation bar here is I have given the black touch here to the navigation bar, You can see the name of the bank here, and then home button, and also our customer item. So our customer and transfer history, and then current converter. This navigation item which is I've added here is that I'll show you what is it. See as I opened this currency converter, it took me to another website because I have linked this website with this data item. So yeah, that's why it took us there on there. So what does this website do? This website basically converts the rupees into another currency, or any other currency you want to convert into another currency, you can use it for that. So let us move back to our website. So after carousel, this is the about us section of the website, in which there is some information about the bank and when it was formed, and how many branches it have, and basically just adding adding something to the front page of the website. Then there's a disclaimer. In this disclaimer, I have written that this is a project work. Project works, it does not represent any views of any organization or any individual. So this project can be used for educational purposes and all. So this is a disclaimer for that. Now let us move towards our flow of the website, which is to view all. First is to view all customers here. We'll go and view our customers. So this window here shows us all the customers which we have, which the bank has. So there's a account number of the customer, then account holder name, then email ID, then account balance. Yeah, so what we have to do here is we will take one account and transfer money using that to another account. So let us take an account here. Let us take Nikki here. Okay, we will take Nikki's account and we will transfer money. So when I click on transfer money, it opens another window, which is easy money transfer window. Okay, in which in this window, as you can see, I have made a table. That table here, which shows all the details of the account through which we will transfer the money to another account. Now let us choose which account we have to transfer the money. Okay, so we will choose from here, and let us send the money to Arjun here. Okay, let's send money to Arjun. Now he is having 4,000 rupees right now. Okay, and Nikki is having 34,800. Let us send him 800 rupees for now. See, as you can see, a pop-up message came that hooray, transaction is coming successful. So we'll click OK here, and now it will redirect us to the transfer history page. Now in this page, there is the this is basically showing the transfer history of all the transactions made using this website here, and you can see here the latest is at the down, Nikki to Arjun, 800 rupees. The amount which we transferred is showing here, and the time and date also it is showing us here. So this is basically our whole function of the website here. Now when we go back to our customers, you can see there is an updated value to the customer name and customer account balance. So yeah, that's that means the transaction was successful. So let us see what all errors will come when we transfer money from one account to another. So let us take one account here. Let us take Gaurav here. So now we will use Gaurav to send money to another account. Let us send account. Let us send money to Arjun. So what will happen if we will type a negative number to send? Let us send negative 2,000 rupees. Let us see what will happen. As you can see, there is a error showing up. That is error negative value. A negative value can't be transferred. So that's why that error popped up. Now Let us send money to another account. Let us send to Ankit. Just try sending an amount which exceeds the amount in the account, in the sender's account. So let us send him 4 lakh rupees. And we will click on transfer money. As you can see, another error popped up, error insufficient balance, which is true because you can't send money if the if there is not that much money in the sender's account. So now let us see the what will happen if we will type zero value in the amount and we will send to another account. Let us choose one account. Let us choose Sidhu here, and we will send him 0 rupees. Let us click on the transfer money. See, as you can see here, the error is showing up. Zero value cannot be transferred, which is true. So let us go to home now. So overall, this was my submission for the Sparks Foundation internship task. I hope you all understood it, and I hope it was informative. Thank you.